Container Threat Detection, KTD, is a built-in service in Security Command Center Premium. It can detect the most common container runtime attacks and provide alerts in Security Command Center and optionally in cloud logging. Container Threat Detection includes multiple detection capabilities, an analysis tool, and an API. To enable Container Threat Detection, first make sure you have Security Command Center Admin and Security Center Sources Admin IAM roles, along with the SCC Premium subscription. On the SCC homepage, go to the Sources page. If you're a Premium Security Command Center subscriber, you can click the toggle next to Container Threat Detection to enable it. In your Cloud SCC dashboard, you will find the Container Threat Detection card listing current findings. In our environment, there is one finding. Some examples of the types of findings that KTD can surface include added binary executions. This finding triggers when a binary that was not part of the original container image was executed. If an added binary is executed, it's a possible sign that an attacker has control of the workload and they are executing unwanted software, such as malware or cryptocurrency mining software. Added binary loaded. This finding triggers when a library that was not part of the original container image was loaded. If an added library is loaded, it's a possible sign that an attacker has control of the workload and they are executing arbitrary code. Reverse shell. This finding triggers when a process started with stream redirection to a remote connected socket. An attacker can use reverse shell to communicate from a compromised workload to an attacker-controlled machine. With this capability, the attacker can control the workload to perform malicious actions, for example, as part of a botnet. You can learn more about these detections in the documentation link below. When Container Threat Detection generates findings, you can view them in Security Command Center or in Cloud Logging if you have configured Security Command Center syncs to write to Google Cloud's Operations Suite. To produce sample findings for us to act on, we've set up a cluster on Kubernetes Engine in a project within our organization. Using Cloud Shell, you can trigger an added binary executed finding by dropping a binary in our container and executing it. Once we access the cluster control plane, we can deploy the latest Ubuntu 18.04 image, copy bin/ls to another location, and then execute it. You can trigger a reverse shell finding by deploying the latest Ubuntu 18.04 image and copying in a library that was not part of the original container image. This example deploys the latest Ubuntu 18.04 image, copies the library libcso6 to another location, and then loads it using ld. You can also trigger a reverse shell finding by starting a binary with standard input redirection to a TCP connected socket. This example starts bin echo with redirection to the Google public DNS 8.8.8.8 on the DNS port. You can find these commands in the link below. To view findings, navigate to the threats dashboard in Security Command Center. Our findings are listed as critical threats. Drilling in, you can find detailed information on the source properties tab about the source container, including environment variables, process arguments, and Kubernetes labels. You can share this finding with your team and remediate by heading to the source. Congratulations, you've just completed setting up Container Threat Detection. You can now detect and be alerted to the most common container runtime attacks from the Google Cloud Console or Cloud Audit Logging.